Good day everyone. This is Dr. Vijay Sundar Singh. I am assistant professor in the department of critical care medicine from Dr. D.Y. Patel Medical College Hospital and Research Center, Pimpri. And this is my colleague, Dr. Sagar Ganjale. He is consultant intensivist in our department. And these are our fellow residents, Dr. Amey, Dr. Aditya, and Dr. Saurabh Kapoor. This is the simulator we have in our department. This is one of its kind in the entire country. This is a simulator which was designed with the collaboration of St. John's Medical College, Bangalore and Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. This is a very advanced simulator where we can simulate various kinds of hemodynamic conditions, hemodynamic monitoring, various ECG scenarios, ventilators, graphics and ventilator scenarios can be simulated through it. And we have two iPads which are provided with this simulator. One is for the trainer and one is for the trainee. And through this iPad interaction, we can even question or interact with the trainee by showing various images such as CT, X-rays, blood gas analysis. Almost all the various aspects of critical care can be trained through this simulator. So we'll go ahead with the class today. Today we'll be seeing the various some of the important ECG scenarios or ECG rhythms which you will be coming across in the ICU. And these two monitors, this is the monitor which will display you all the vitals of the patient. So without much further ado, we'll go into the first scenario. So I would like Dr. Aditya to identify what is the ECG rhythm which is being displayed in the monitor.
So this is polymorphic VT, especially towards the pointers.
Yeah. Can you just now tell me, like, why did you identify this as such polymorphic ventricular tachycardia?
So the amplitude and the rate keeps on changing. There is no P wave, plus it is tachycardic.
Yeah. The main thing is, like, there is a twisting of axis, that's why you have termed it as torsades T points. Okay, this is a very common ECG which we come across in our ICUs. Can you tell me, like, what will be the causes, particularly in an ICU patient, for this rhythm?
In an ICU setup, sir, the most common cause is myocardial ischemia.
Yeah, very
followed
good.
Followed by dyselectrolemia, especially hypokalemia and hypomagnesemia.
Good.
Yeah. Other causes are prolonged QT syndrome.
Can you just tell me some other ECG condition prior to this which can lead on to this rhythm?
Sir, multiple VPCs with R-on-T phenomena especially can lead to these conditions.
Yeah, good. Can you tell me how will you manage a patient who has got this ECG rhythm?
Sir, this ECG rhythm patient will be pulseless. We will start with chest compression, CPR protocol, followed by defibrillation simultaneously, magnesium sulfate IV, and correction of dyselectrolemia, whatever are there.
Yeah, good.
Hello all, I'm Dr. Sagar Ganjale. I'm a consultant intensivist in the Department of Critical Care Medicine in Dr. D.Y. Patel Medical College and Hospital, Pimpri, Pune. So today our session is on the ECG. So I would like to show some ECGs here. So Dr. Amey, can you please identify the rhythm in the monitor?
Sir, this rhythm is of atrial fibrillation. The pulse is irregular. The E wave is absent. Fibrillation waves are present, instead which are confusing with the E wave. This is atrial fibrillation.
Okay, so can you please tell me what would be the causes for this rhythm in the ICU setting?
IHD, post cardiac surgery, beta blocker withdrawal.
Yes.
Rheumatic heart diseases.
Yes.
Valvular heart diseases.
Yes.
MSMR.
Dyselectrolemia,
especially hypokalemia.
Yes.
Then
So what else?
Hypertensive,
heart disease, rarely idiopathic, alcohol abuse, post-cardiac surgery, yes. Chronic pulmonary diseases.
Chronic
pulmonary. So in ICU setting, how will you manage such kind of arrhythmias?
We'll start with anti-arrhythmic drugs, mm-hmm. such as amiodarone.
Mm-hmm.
We'll start with 150 milligram bolus over 10 minutes.
Okay.
Rapid progression.
Yes.
After that, slowly 1 milligram per minute for 8 hours.
Okay.
And then we'll add infusion of 340 milligram of amiodarone for over 18 hours.
Okay.
0.5 milligram
okay.
per minute.
Okay. Yes.
Dose.
So what else? How will you manage? Beta blockers.
We'll treat with beta blockers.
Mm-hmm.
For rate.
Okay.